two of them at first.
Oh my god, that's it. They're reacting. Look at how it's coming together. That energy that's arcing between them, no manufactured material in the settled systems can do that. None of them. This proves.
Easy, girl. Breathe. You'll have a heart attack.
She's not the only one. If they're coming together, that means there's a set.
Built by an intelligence outside the settled systems.
Still 2,000 credits for our little wager, Godfrey?
You're on, Walter.
Well, if we had all the answers, it wouldn't be exciting, now would it?
Not to take away from the moment, but what are we going to do about our new friend?
So, are you ready to get to work? See if exploration is the life you want to lead in this little universe of ours? You should take some time to get settled in. Introduce yourself to everyone. Some of our members aren't here, but you'll meet them soon. Come find me when you're ready. You and I are going to be doing some traveling together. Get your feet wet. And here, I think you've earned something for bringing the artifact to us. In addition to credits, why don't we set you up with a backpack with some boost capability? Hmm? You'll need it out in the field anyway. Just mind your head.
Not even at your service, Captain.
Yeah. That's funny.
You are a member of Constellation. I am at your service. No additional protocols necessary. Also, given the likelihood that you will be out in unsettled space, it might be beneficial to go over exploration outpost development. In case you ever need to build a base for field research. The exploration of an unknown planet can be a major undertaking. By building an outpost, you will be able to construct scanning equipment, resource extractors, and defenses. It is even possible to set up multiple outposts capable of manufacturing, allowing you to build advanced equipment. The scan booster is the most obvious, as it will enable you to detect landmarks and other points of interest from further away. Beyond that, extractors will allow you to collect raw materials of various types, while fabricators enable the manufacturing. A particularly prosperous outpost may even warrant the construction of cargo links, allowing you to share resources between other outposts you have built. The blueprints you need to construct an outpost should already be on your watch. It will automatically connect to any available materials for construction in your ship's cargo. Captain, I will proceed to my assigned post. Yes, Captain.
The well's been having brownouts all the time. Mast finally sent someone down there, but nothing's changed.
Abilities, and to uphold the values of the Vanguard, honor, loyalty, self-reliance in all your actions as members of the United Colonies Navy?
I do.
Then I'm proud to welcome you to the Vanguard. Now, you all have your assignments. Get out there and show them what the UC's made of. Supra et ultra. You look like you know how to handle yourself. Know how to fly? Vanguard might well have a place for you.
Have a good one.
Seems like the kill for a cup of coffee right about now.
Everyone, hi. How you doing? I used to be in taking a look at your file. Bounty hunter. All right, just keep the chaos to a minimum. No collateral damage, okay?
Welcome to Yes? You needed something? This is Mast, the beating heart of the United Colonies. Every decision made in the civilized galaxy takes place inside these walls. I'm one of Mast's resource officers. It's my job to ensure those here on official business get where they're going promptly, and that any rule-breaking is dealt with swiftly. Most of Mast's employees have extensive training in their specific areas of expertise. But if you're interested in joining the UC, Commander Tuala of the Vanguard is just on the far side of the room. The Vanguard's open to anyone who can fly. Take care now.
What do we got here? Another applicant to the UC Vanguard? Interested in doing some good for the people of the United Colonies, all while earning your citizenship and credits to boot? Well, other than becoming a member of the greatest faction in the galaxy, you'd get access to discounted services on any UC world. Credits to help you get on your feet. You'd even be able to buy property right here in New Atlantis. Citizenship unlocks it all. And signing up for the Vanguard is the fastest way to earn it. We're the United Colonies Volunteer Fleet. Any captain can join, regardless of origin. Get to fly your own ship and earn credits as you help the people in the most distant reaches of the United Colonies. All while earning your way to UC citizenship. Put in the time, and citizenship is guaranteed. Glad to hear it. Signing up simple. All you've got to do is pass a fight exam and make it through one probationary mission and you're in. We'll have you working your way to UC citizenship in no time. Well, other than you'd even be able to buy Vanguard work is as needed. When we've got jobs, we'll make them available to you. But the work itself, well, it runs the gamut. Sometimes you might be hunting down hostile ships on behalf of the UC Navy, or you might be called up to help the science division clean up some invasive species. Hell, we've even been asked to help take on the occasional Terramorph. And sometimes we just need cargo support. Not every job's glamorous. The Vanguard only gets called in for the ones where there's a chance of seeing action. Wherever the UC needs us, the Vanguard is there. Well, all right. Take the elevator down to the Vanguard orientation hall. You can get started at any of the registration terminals. The system will walk you through the rest. And if you've got any questions, I'm happy to answer them.
Registration accepted. You may now proceed through the historical displays in the orientation hall, or continue on to the examination.
In 2050, humanity learned the Earth's magnetosphere would collapse sometime in the next half century, eliminating all
How
life
can I
on
be
the planet.
Service returning to assignment, Captain.
Was required, but the secure transport of an entire civilization would demand a new kind of cooperation, a new kind of courage, and a new kind of union. Thus, in 2159, the United Colonies were formed to make that journey possible. Just 1 year later, the Galileo, the first of many colony ships, touched down here on Jemison, beginning a new era of human history. Of the United Colonies.
Is broken, I'll call up to maintenance.
Oh, didn't even notice if one was broken.
From their foundation, the United Colonies strove to provide all their citizens with opportunity, security, and peace. But there were those among the UC that still wanted something more. So in 2161, the UC issued the Centaurus Proclamation, granting UC citizens the right to settle distant worlds and form their own sovereign powers. It wasn't long before the first new faction, the Free Star Collective, was formally organized in 2188, later followed by House Varun, revealing themselves to the universe in 2230. It was only in 2230 that the faction known as House Varun first made contact with the rest of the settled systems. collapses and disappeared 4 decades earlier, House Varun was a faction unlike any other. A theocracy dedicated wholly to the beliefs of its isolationist founder, Jinan Varun. House Varun initially made overtures of peace towards the rest of the settled systems. They claimed their only intention was to spread the word of their god, the Great Serpent. But none could have guessed that this worship might take the form of a bloody war, the Serpent's Crusade. The Freestar Collective was initially founded in 2188, when the citizens of Aquila banded together with the pleasure city of Neon in mutual defense. But in 2194, after the deployment of a UC medical star station in orbit around their world, the citizens of Narion also requested to join the collective. The resulting rise in tensions between the Freestar Collective and UC culminated in the settled system's first intergalactic conflict, the Narion War. Despite a decisive victory by the UC, the colonies permitted the citizens of Narion to join the collective, forming the basis for the fiercely independent union that persists to this day. Beginning in 2240, House Varun forces declared all-out war on the rest of human civilization, initiating the Serpent's Crusade. The next 23 years, thousands of Freestar, UC, and independent souls were killed by agents of House Varun in the name of their serpent god. It was only with the death of their founder in 2263 and the succession of his heir, Jarek, that House Varun finally sued for peace. There remains, however, select members of House Varun who refuse to recognize the cessation of hostilities their leaders established. Even after House Varun's mysterious disappearance, these zealots remain a threat to all who encounter them, their pacification a goal of all space. Between the galaxy's factions, none was more brutal than the recent colony war between the UC and the Freestar Collective. Set off by the unauthorized Freestar colonization of Vesta's Pride in 2308, a direct violation of the Narion Treaty, the colony war spread quickly across the galaxy. Both sides deployed every tool at their disposal. Armadas of warships, mechanized combat platforms, or mechs, even bio-engineered alien creatures, the infamous UC Xeno weapons. It was only in 2311 at the Battle of Cheyenne that the scales finally tipped, the Freestar Collective utilizing their civilian fleet as a human shield successfully crippled the superior United Colonies Navy. After their shocking victory against the galaxy's greatest navy, the Freestar Collective offered terms of peace, which the colonies, out of an interest in staving off any further human costs, accepted.
That's my type of people.
Rebuilding ever since. Few settled worlds were left untouched by the colony war. But nowhere could the viciousness of modern warfare be seen more clearly than on the Freestar planet of Nera. Initially occupied by invading United Colonies forces as a forward operating position, repeated attempts to take and retake the planet by collective forces led only to devastation. Swaths of the world were transformed into scorched husks, a nightmarish testament to the depths of human ingenuity and human cruelty. And today, Nera continuing reminder to the horrors of unfettered war.
Nera. Okay.
This thing's like an artist's rendition, right? No animal can be this ugly in real life. I bring her here almost every day to stare at this thing.
Dad wanted all four of my last science papers have been on Terramorphs.
In the midst of the colony war, a different kind of tragedy struck the UC city of Londinian. A newly constructed but critical supply center for the United Colonies war effort.
No one
Londinian
knows how
found
they
itself
move
overrun
planets.
By one of the galaxy's most mysterious predators, the Terramorph. A rare but pervasive threat to all human-settled worlds, Terramorphs swept over the city, seemingly out of nowhere, on a scale never before seen in recorded history. Valiant efforts by the UC military slowed the onslaught, but the creatures proved unstoppable. Ultimately, the decision was made to destroy the Londinian spaceport, sealing off the city, the outbreak, and its citizenry from the galaxy at large. The tragedy of Londinian is mourned by the UC to this day.
I can't stop staring at it. A real Terramorph.
After the devastation wrought by the colony war, the UC and the Freestar Collective came together to ratify a treaty that became known as the Armistice. Both sides agreed to a vast reduction in standing forces, and that xenoweapons and mech warfare would be outlawed. All related research was sealed away, accessible only in cases of dire emergency. But the Collective had another demand, that the active commanders of the UC military stand trial for their actions. The United Colonies, in the interest of peace and galactic security, agreed. In 2311, three United Colonies senior officers were found guilty. Commander Henry Durant, General Indira Rastogi, and Fleet Admiral Francois Senon, known better as Ve Victis. All were sentenced to death for their actions, bringing the colony war to a close and returning peace to the galaxy at long last. Regardless of origin, the Vanguard is leading the charge to protect and support the citizens of the United Colonies, wherever in the galaxy they may be.
I'm doing my part. It's like Starship Troopers.
than their foreign counterparts for needs big and small. All citizens are issued a grant upon joining to get themselves on their feet. And only UC citizens have the opportunity to purchase property, getting the chance to live in one of the most beautiful cities in the settled systems. By joining the Vanguard today, you too can begin earning your place here, in the heart of galactic civilization, as a citizen of the United Colonies.
You must be our new applicant. I'm Proctor Samuelson. The simulator's already been prepped. You can head in whenever you're ready. Vanguard assignments can often include both space and ground combat. It'd be bad for both you and the United Colonies to not ensure you're adept in both Just head in whenever you're ready.
Yeah.
Progress recorded. Tier 1 reached. Initiating Tier 2. New targets active.
Where?
Targets defeated.
Ooh, he fast.
Score, or stay and try your hand at the remaining tiers.
3 tiers of opponents to complete the exam. Good hunting, applicant.
I don't like...
New targets active.
Let's keep it going.
Congratulations, applicant. You've defeated sufficient opponents to pass the exam. You can exit the simulator through the hatch to record your current score.
Nah.
Stay and try your hand at the remaining tiers.
We going for it. No, this will be.
Here.
Target defeated.
buddy.
Target defeated. This is from the top.
Oh shit. Oh no.
Congratulations, applicant. You've passed. You can help.
Yeah. I passed, but...
Up to Commander Tuwala to receive your final results.
Nah. Nah. Where that sucker at, huh? Yeah. Came out of nowhere.
Tier 4 reached. Initiating Tier 5. New targets active.
me. The shield. Hold on.
Target defeated.
Yeah, shields are fine. These suckers ain't nothing.
Is this your first time flying? Target defeated.
That's it. I can't see him.
Good showing in there, applicant.
Thank you.
destroyed 30 ships. Whatever, man. Excuse me.
Look who's back. Everything go all right with the exam? Or did you have some questions you needed answered first? MASS is short for Military Administrative and Scientific Triumvirate. From here, the three co-equal divisions of the UC government work together to advance the cause of the colonies. Be that through mutual defense, political and diplomatic strength, or scientific discovery. Now. Serving any of the UC's divisions grants citizenship, but scientific and admin positions in the UC tend to be real competitive. Understandable. Most people would prefer to earn their citizenship behind a desk rather than in combat. Not something I'd ever choose for myself, but understandable. So these are your numbers that just came through then. You ready to hear how you did? Well, let's get to it then. So, looking at the data, hit every mural in the orientation hall, huh? A test of preparation and thoroughness. Two traits the Vanguard values highly. Psychological results are all within expected levels. Navy doesn't have room for folks that'll fall apart the first time they're trying to outrun a homing missile. Now, how'd you do against your foes? Clear tier 5, huh? Damn impressive. I swear they start cheating at that level, but the techs claim it's fair. Either way, you've got the skills the Navy needs. So then, looking at your results as a whole, and presuming you're successful in completing your probationary mission, you could have your UC citizenship after only 5 years. You showed real potential in there. We want to make sure you're fighting on our side. Even authorized me to offer you a bonus in addition to your signing advance. Sounds like you're just the type of pilot the Vanguard's looking for. If you're interested, we could bring you on as a provisional member today. Get you the credits you've earned, then send you out on your probationary. first, though. All UC service people, provisional or otherwise, are required to swear an oath. So, you want to make this official? Commit yourself to the cause of the colonies? Fantastic. Then just follow me. Be right doing this where we couldn't see the stars. Now, raise your right hand. The motto of the Vanguard is Supra et Ultra, above and beyond. That is where we serve, beyond the furthest reaches of the United Colonies military, and with honor and duty above reproach. Do you swear to protect and defend the citizens of the United Colonies to the best of your abilities, and to uphold the values of the Vanguard, honor, loyalty, self-reliance, in all your actions as a member of the United Colonies Navy? Then let me be the first to officially welcome you to the United Colonies Vanguard. Now, only thing left is getting you that probationary mission. And what I've got is comms repair. Group trying to refurb an old colony war processing plant on Tau Ceti 2. Sounds like they'd barely gotten set up when their communications died. Place is as isolated as they come, so Brass wants a Vanguard to deliver the repair suite and ensure anyone present is safe and secure. So, can the people of Tau Ceti 2 count on you? That's the spirit. Head down to the spaceport and talk to Crew Chief Harath. He'll get you the repair suite plus your new recruit kit. Oh, and your advance. Give it your all out there. Supra et Ultra.
6,600? Man, who the fudge?
it for leeches, get it fixed up, and let her know we'll have it ready as soon as we can.
Ah, you are new probationary then? Crew Chief Herat, pleasure to be working with you.
It's my job to make sure all you rocket jockeys are ready for anything that comes at you up there. Now, Manifest says we're fitting you out with one comms repair suite.
In addition to the standard issue welcome kit all probationary pilots get for their first mission.
Med packs, some small arms, couple spare ship parts, all the essentials in case of any surprises up there. My people will have everything on your ship before you lift off. Won't even know they were there. So, paying a visit to the people of scenic Tau Ceti II. Nice easy one for your first job. Just keep your head on swivel and you'll come home safe. Any questions before you head out? Then I won't keep you.
Make us look good out there, recruit.
Let's go.
accompany you as long as you require.
All right, that'll be it for tonight.